Okay, I'm gonna try it a couple of different ways. I'm gonna try with a fillet knife just so I can see if. Okay. That's actually not as bad as they made it sound. Meat's not that dark. Pretty sure there's a bloodline though. It's not too bad. I'll clean that up in a little bit. Wash that blood off. As you see here, that is a load of blood in their spine right there. Actually, not bad. I was expecting a lot worse. This is right here is what people don't like right here, and I'll show you how to clean that off. Okay, one down. I would try the fillet knife, but honestly, I think the reason they get so bloody is because it takes longer than it should to cut the meat off. That tail piece. Wash that blood off. Make a mess. And those who do not use an electric fillet knife, I'm going to tell you right now, once you get to learn how to use them, it's going to be one of the best investments you've ever made if fish is a part of your diet. Okay. Tried not to put so much pressure on that one. And these guys put up a very hard fight. Alright, I'm going to wash these. Cutting board. Just really want to see where that blood is. Okay. First, wow, it's really bony fish. First off, I'm gonna go ahead and take that rib off. Probably not gonna keep any of that bottom. Wasn't too bad. Okay, bony fish. There you go. Not too bad. As long as you get that bloodline off of there. You're not going to have a lot of fish, a lot of meat from this catch because they were so small. But in my experience, smaller fish taste better than the larger ones because they didn't live as long. They didn't have enough time to get mercury buildup or any other nasties. Right. I'm gonna keep that. I'm not going to keep anything off that rib cage.